What up, what up, what up, Unbreakable Kicks Army. If y'all haven't been catching the videos this week, I want to say we haven't missed one day of uploading. So make sure that you guys go and check out all the videos. I hit the Nike outlet again for y'all. I also did the Air Jordan 1 Travis Scott Low video. So make sure y'all checking out all of the videos that I've been posting this past week. Now let's get into the video. Now, I had a member of the Army send me this post yesterday that I posted on my Instagram last night, and for a hot second, it kind of made me, not necessarily sad, but I think it made me more grateful than anything. Because if you've been collecting sneakers, buying sneakers, been in the sneaker culture, been in the sneaker game, whatever y'all like to call it, if you've been in it for, I say, at least 10 plus years, you've literally been through many phases. I'm talking about almost like a Marvel movie. Phase 1, phase 2, phase 3, phase 4. I want to go back to before we had a StockX, you know, when eBay was the main source of buying sneakers. That could be like phase 1. Then we had like the Nike Talks where you can, you know, do transactions via Nike Talk. Then you got the days of StockX, and now you got the days of today. Now, I mean, that's pretty much my 10-year fold. You can go before that as well, like the East Bay catalogs, and actually walking in a store on release day and still being able to grab shoes. So all the members of the Army, y'all come in what era of sneaker buying that you live in? Is it the starter jacket era where you couldn't even walk down the street rocking a starter jacket? I remember my pops used to tell me, like, man, back in the early 90s, having a Chicago Bulls starter jacket with the hood, you know, putting your hands right here in the pocket, you was going to get robbed rocking one of those if you wasn't known in the neighborhood. Like, we got it, I want to say these sneakerheads today got it so easy. Well, all they have to do is pick up their phone, go to an app, click buy now. You know, granted, 9 out of 10, you're going to be paying more for the shoes, but just the hunt back in the day, and I'm even saying the hunt from when I used to stand in line in like 2012 for Fire Red 4s, or when the Air Jordan 6 Olympics came back out. You know, like, even those days to me was great, because even standing in line then, I don't recommend standing in line now. I personally wouldn't stand in line now unless it's like a legit personal pair on a sneaker that I know is going to be hard for me to get for retail down the line again. But you got to think of all the relationships that were made, you know, standing in line. Most people that stood in line or camped early until the store opened, most of those was good people who just wanted the shoes. Most of the time, you just have to worry about the people who come in 10, 15 minutes before the store opened up, seeing a long line and trying to cut the line. That would probably be the only issue that we would have had back then. And Army, I know I went on a completely different tangent, but again, man, this new generation of sneakerheads, I just spoiled to the fact that they can click a button, then their shoes can be popped up at their door within weeks. Now, again, that is a more of a convenient way, but back in the day, man, and again, I'm still young. I'm only 30 now. Still, back in my day, because I can say that, back in my day, it was the chase for the shoe. It was that, you know, man, I'm next in line to come in the store, praying that they still got my size 11 or 11 and a half, or heck, if I'm being extra thirsty, I take a 10 and a half. Okay, so Army, that's just that little bitty tangent. But back to this photo. So this photo right here is clear as day from 2017. And seeing this photo low key makes me wish that I did not sell my alternate Motorsports. I did keep my OG Motorsports. I did wind up keeping these joints right here. Still ain't bust them out. But man, oh man, was this a beautiful shoe when it first came out. You know, all it was just a blue version of the Fire Red 4. And if you see the price on here, it says $114.97, because the joints went on sale. This was back when sneakers was going on sale on Nike.com. When I posted this yesterday, I had so many people hitting me up, "Break, where is that on the Nike app? I don't see that on the Nike app." First off, y'all didn't even read the status that I put on this joint. I said, man, when you can actually see on release day, nah, I'ma wait for them to go on sale. Stuff ain't the same no more, man. Who's to blame? Now, when I asked the question, who's to blame, I was getting, I don't know, I want to say mixed, you know, results from people or mixed reactions. A lot of people was actually blaming this on The Last Dance. And I don't know if I can 100% blame all of this on The Last Dance. I still kind of got to put it in the hands of Nike, because Nike is not making more sneakers to go with the higher demand of sneakerheads we have now. There's more sneakerheads now than it was in 2017. So if you're still putting out the same amount of quantity that you were putting out in 2017 and 2021, we will have this issue. If Nike was to simply triple the amount of sneakers that they put out per release, we won't have these issues. But y'all gotta remember, and when I was heavy into reselling, I said that Nike loves resellers. And I'm not saying they hugging them in public and dapping them up in public, but the more these resellers are increasing the price of these sneakers, selling them out, making Nike still the hottest commodity, it's helping them. It's free advertisement, number one, and Nike is just like, hey, if these idiots, I'm gonna keep it a buck, but if they like, hey, if these idiots are willing to pay $700 for a shoe that we got for $190, why can't we make the shoe $220? We can increase the margin of the shoe however many percent, let's just say 10%, which is not, but let's just say, hey, if we increase the margin, the retail margin of the shoe by 10%, they not gonna care, because it's still cheaper than what they're paying on the street. Nike loves it. In front of the camera, they don't, oh, we gotta try to get rid of these botters, But behind the scenes, it's helping them push sales. They can't even keep all white Air Force Ones on the shelf. A basic sneaker that used to be like, what, $70? Now they went up 20 bucks and they still selling out, and now they reselling for 150. So yes, resellers are definitely increasing the price on a shoe, but Nike not doing nothing to stop the resellers. At the end of the day, I feel like all of this is in the hands of Nike. Nike is controlling all this. Now, I'm not sure if Nike is silent promoters on like Gold or StockX. Foot Locker is an investor in Flight Club and Go. They said that. We got record of that. But we don't have any record of Nike saying, hey, we are putting money into these third-party apps that are selling our shoes at 10 times the value. And it's because of that, that's why I cannot fully put all the blame on resellers. Do resellers have a part in today's reason why shoes are so high and getting sold out? Yes. But there was resellers back in 2017, but the demand wasn't that high. So again, that's probably where y'all coming at with the whole Last Dance. But then again, the demand for the Air Jordan 1 started shooting up around 2016 when they redid the Bred Ones. 2016, you had the Bred Ones. 2017, you had the Royal Ones. 2018, you had the Shadows. You know, before the Breds, you had 2015 Chicagos. So it was resellers out here. But what was the switch? And the switch to me is StockX. StockX go all of those. Once those platforms got big, because I don't think StockX was as big in like 2016. StockX ain't really start getting big to like 2017, 2018. So 2015, 2016, you still had resellers, but it was like a different monster. And I'm sure you still even had bottom back then. I say the Crave. And I'm gonna say it one more time, the Crave, like a White Castle's Crave case. The Crave came in 2011 when we got the Concord 11s and those Galaxy phones. Galaxy phones, Concord 11s started this massive, not necessarily hypebeast, because hypebeast was not a terminology back in 2011. It was not. I want to say sneaker YouTubers started this whole hypebeast trend. But we had Concord 11s in 2011 and the Galaxy phones. Those are the two that started this modern day hype for shoes, this modern day resale for shoes. Concord 11s was busting on eBay back in 2011. Concord 11s was on eBay $300, $400, $500. So again, eBay was the workhorse for resale back in the day. And now again, going back to the picture, 2017, you got the Air Jordan 1 Red Metallics. I got them somewhere up in the vault right here. Jordan 1 Red Metallics. Now, a lot of people were saying, oh, break capping, when I told y'all I got these off Nike on sale for $90. Y'all see it right here. These joints was $94. Now, I also was able to get the blue metallics, but I want to say I got those at an outlet. I want to say I got them at the Chicago outlet, but still got them on sale. Air Jordan 7 Pantones. I got those for sale, and the Chutneys. I remember grabbing the 4s early because the 4s dropped at the Jordan store downtown. God rest that store, man. That store used to be so clutch. It is no longer what it used to be. But I remember the weekend of All-Star Weekend. It wasn't in Chicago that year, but they dropped those early just to celebrate All-Star Weekend. I remember grabbing 2 pairs, paid retail for them, and then I wound up returning them because they went on sale on Nike.com. It was before there was a limit on how many shoes you can buy on Nike.com. You could easily just buy whatever. Now, again, this is kind of like the beginning of when, like, the Yeezy started getting big, too. So, Yeezy was definitely having a lot of people's attention, and that's probably why a lot of these Jordans was not selling out. 2017, Yeezys was definitely the craze. And Jordans didn't really start picking up again to like 2018, I'm telling y'all. So, it's hard for me to just say that the Last Dance was the reason why we got this craze. So again, Army, in the comment section below, y'all let me know what y'all think started this. Y'all let me know, is this long gone? Y'all think that we can go back to the days where we can get on Nike.com and find any Air Jordan on sale? When was the last Air Jordan that was on sale? Was probably those Air Jordan 7 Hair 2.0s that dropped, what, like 2 years ago. And those are just like god awful anyway. But we haven't seen a screen like this in forever. And then another member of the Army also sent me a picture of him buying his Air Jordan 4 Pure Monies, and he wound up getting them for $114.97. And all of these shoes now are going $300+ right now. Maybe not the Chutneys or the Retro 7s, but the Motorsports and these ones definitely going $300+. And before I get up out of here, Army, I just want to mention one word that I haven't heard in years until I posted this post. And that's a swoosh account. Some of these new sneakerheads probably never even heard of a swoosh account. And I'm just thinking like when some of my bros had swoosh accounts and we was eating, because y'all remember when they just had the regular draw on sneakers and shoes did not sell out? Then 5-10 minutes later, your friend was able to, hey, did you want them? Because I can use my swoosh account and get whatever, the 30% off. We were getting 30% off retros back in the day. 30% off if you had a buddy who worked at Nike and was using his swoosh account. Nothing sits on Nike long enough for us to even use a swoosh account. Now, that may be another thing that Nike did in order to stop its employees from taking advantage of the discount program that y'all gave them. Because if we're doing a draw, literally, I haven't seen one shoe on the draw that after the draw, it was not sold out. I haven't seen it. So if after the draw it's saying sold out, how can you use a swoosh account? And again, for those who don't know what a swoosh account is, it's a discount that the Nike employees had that they can use for family, okay? Not friends and family, but Muggs was definitely eating off of them swoosh accounts back in the day. And Nike knows that a lot of its employees are resellers now. So they probably like, y'all resellers are not about to be using this program to help sell shoes. I'm sure some rules against that, and Nike just like, y'all can keep these swoosh accounts, but we gonna change up everything to the point where y'all can't use it unless y'all getting on some shirts or some socks or some stuff in the store that's just sitting. That's crazy, y'all. The times have changed so much. So again, Army, y'all let me know in the comment section below if y'all remember these days. Y'all let me know, how can we get back to it, or is it just so far gone and we can never get back to those days? I feel like those days are so much in the past that we will never be able to get back to them. And other than that, you got your boy Unbreakable. You got the Unbreakable Vault. You got the clean Unbreakable Vault. It took me like 2 hours to clean this room up yesterday. Unbreakable Army, I love you guys. Stand strong like always, and like the merch says, hug your loved ones. And we out.